Now, let's have a quick overview of the operations we can perform over dictionaries. Now, we have all the commands over here and all the results of those commands over here. Now, first of all, there are different ways we can create a dictionary. We have already seen how we can create a dictionary and how we can work with the dictionaries, but then there are other ways also you can create a dictionary. So as you know that dictionaries contain key value pairs. So instead of indexing, you can refer to a particular value by using the key associated with it. So over here we have a dictionary D containing a key name associated with a value ABC. Then we have L name containing a value XYZ, and then we have age as 22. So these are the different keys and associated with different pair of values. Now we have simply print D. So as you can see over here, we have this available to us over here. Now the second way you can create a dictionary is, first of all, you can simply create a First of all, you can simply create an empty dictionary not containing any key value pairs, and later on you can simply provide different keys and different pairs to it. So as you can see, we have a dictionary named as small d, which does not contain anything, and then we have different keys. So the name key contains ABC, the L name key contains XYZ, and the age key contains 22. So you can also explicitly provide key value pairs instead of giving it initially. So it also provides us with the same result as the previous one. Next, we have another way in which we can initialize a dictionary. So over here, we use the dict keyword to refer to the dictionary. So we have simply written dict, inside which we pass in key value pairs like we do previously. So you just need to provide key and value pair names inside the dict keyword and assign it to a certain dictionary variable, which is H. So as soon as we are printing H, look at this, it again gives us the same result as its previous results. So there are basically three ways you can initialize a dictionary. Now, we have seen that we can find out the length of a list and length of other data types also, and you can similarly find out the length of a dictionary as well using the len keyword. So len is a function through which you can just pass inside it the name of your dictionary, and it is basically going to find out the length of your dictionary. So when we say len h, it gives us the answer as 3. Next, if you want to print out a specific value, you can simply provide the key associated with that value. So when we say print d name, it is going to refer to the d dictionary and refer to the key called as name and print the value associated with it. Now we have d dictionary over here, and we have the value abc associated with name. So look at this, we have abc as a result. Then we have addition and subtraction. Operations can also be applied over different elements of a dictionary. So supposedly inside D dictionary we had a key called age containing an element 22. If we want to add a number to this particular integer key age, we can simply do it by using the addition operator. So when we say D age plus 1, it is basically going to add a 1 to the integer contained by this age value. So now when we print D, look at this, it contains 23 instead of 22. Now moving next, we know that dictionaries are mutable. So if you want to change the value associated with a certain key, you can simply do that by using the assignment operator. So when we say D name is equal to DEF, it is going to simply change the value associated with the name key. So when we print D now, look at this, instead of the name ABC, it provides us with a DEF because it has replaced it. Then we have the deletion operation. If you want to get rid of a certain value, you can simply provide the name of the dictionary and the key associated with that value. So if you want to get rid of the name, you can simply write DEL standing for delete D name. So look at this, we no more have the name key present over here. We just have age, L name, and nothing else. Now, the next way you can delete a certain element is the pop operation. So when you write pop and specify the name of the dictionary, we write d.pop. Inside that, you can simply specify the name of the key whose value you want to get rid of. So we have specified L name, and then we are printing the dictionary D. So the last name was XYZ, as you can see. So it has popped out XYZ. And now when you're gonna print the dictionary D, it is just showing us the age because we have deleted the name parameter and we have popped out the last name parameter. Let's move further. Next we have inserting. So over here we have a nested dictionary. As you know, we can have nested dictionaries, like we can have nested list. So over here we have the first key as name, which contains a nested value. Inside the value we have again key value pairs. So the first key value pair is first Bob, the second being L name William, and then we have the second key, which is jobs, which again contains a list of jobs, which is manager and engineer, and then we have the third key whose value is 45. So when you print this record, we have this record over here. Now what we are trying to do, now supposedly we want to print the value associated with the name's first key. So over here we have the name key, inside it which we have the first key. We want the value associated with this key. We simply write record name first, it will present us with a bob. Next what we are doing, now supposedly we have a list which is nested inside a dictionary, like we have a list over here, the key is job and its value is a list of two different jobs, manager and engineer, and supposedly we want to refer to the list using indexing. As you know, we can refer to list using indexing. So what we are trying to do, we say record jobs 0. So it will refer to the 0th index of the job list. So it will give us a manager. Now, moving further. Now, suppose you give the same name of the keys to two different keys. Over here, we have a dictionary naming X. The first key is nameless. We have not given any name to this key whose value is 1. Then we have the second key, which is again nameless and we don't have any name, whose value is 2. The third key is cut, whose value is apple, and the fourth key is cut again, whose value is banana. So what it is going to do is, it is going to override the previous value if the keys are the same. So first two keys are the same, so it is going to override the first value and it is going to only sustain the second value, which is 2. And similarly, the third and the fourth keys are also same, so it is going to get rid of the first value and only sustain the second value. So when you are going to print X over here, look at this, we have just two key value pairs instead of 4. So we have the first key as space whose value is 2. Why? Because it has overridden the first value, which was 1. And similarly, the second key is cut and it has overridden the first value associated with this key, which was apple, and it only sustained the second value, which is banana. Next, we have the methods of dictionaries. We have various methods associated with dictionaries. We can use keys method to get the various keys inside a dictionary. So we have name, age, and L name. And then we have values operation through which we can get different values. So we have ABC, 22, and XYZ. And then we have various items. Items is going to present us with both key value pairs. We have name, ABC, age, 22, and L name, XYZ. And then we have get operation, which is used to get a certain value using the key of that particular value. So when we say d.getName, it is going to present us with the value associated with the name key, which is nothing but ABC. So that's how you work with dictionaries. Let's move further. Now, apart from dictionaries, we have tuples. Let's find out the results. Okay, over here. Fine. So now we have already seen how we work with tuples in our previous video session. We'll be working with some more operations. So over here we have the first tuple as T, which contains 1, 3, 4, 4 and high. Because tuples are heterogeneous, you can create tuples with one or more types. Then we are simply printing the tuple T, which is printed over here, 1, 3, 4, 4 and high. And then we have the concept of indexing. You can refer to any element of your tuple using indexes like you do with list. So when we say T0, it is going to refer to the first element, the 0th index, which is 1. So we have 1 over here. Then we have the length of the tuple, which can again be found out using the len function. So when we say len T, look at this, it gives us a 5, which is the length of the tuple. And then we can also perform concatenation in tuples as well. So when we say T plus H double I, it is going to concatenate this H double I string in the original tuple. So we have H double I concatenated to the original tuple. Next we have, now we know that tuples are immutable. So once you have concatenated H double I to your original tuple, it is not going to change the original tuple. For the time being, it is going to concatenate H double I to the tuple, but it is not going to change the original tuple. So now if you're going to print the original tuple, it is going to show you exactly what it was earlier. So we don't have H double I in the original tuple. Next, we have the concept of slicing. Now, what do we mean by slicing? Slicing basically means to get rid of a certain value or a certain set of values inside a list or a tuple. So over here, we have written t1:4. Now, what does that mean? It is going to start with the first index, span till the last index, include the first index and exclude the last index, and present you with whatever is left. Now, what our tuple t contains first? Know that a tuple t contains 1, 3, 4, 4 high. Now when we say slice 1:4, what it is going to do, it is going to refer to the first index, which is 3, spanned in the last index, which is 4, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, which is high. It is going to include the first index, which is 3, exclude the fourth index, which is high, and span through it, which becomes 3, 4, 4, which is the final answer. Now, you can concatenate your tuple and customize it any which way you want. So we have seen another way of slicing also in list. We can simply use a colon and refer to the index we want to get rid of. So when we say t1 colon, what it is going to do, it is going to remove the first. So when we say t1 colon, what it is going to do, it is going to slice off the first index of this tuple. Now, it is going to slice off the first value of the tuple, which is nothing but 1. So it slices off 1, which, so we are left off with 3, 4, 4 and high. And then it is concatenating a 2 and a 3 to the existing tuple, which becomes 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5. Now, next we can find out the length of the tuple using the len function. So we have 6 as the length of the tuple. Now there are various methods associated with a tuple. Now you can find out the position of a certain element using the index function. So our name of the tuple is t. When we say t.index and specify index, and we specify a value inside that index function, it will provide us with the index of that value. So when we say t.index 3, we have 3 present at the first index, 0th index and first index, so it is going to give the position as 1. Next we have counting the occurrences of an item. You can simply use the count function. We can say t.count and inside that we can pass in the value we wish to count. So when we say t.count 4, it is going to count how many times 4 has occurred in the tuple. So we have 2 times. So it says number of 4 in tuple 2. Then we have nesting, like we had nested dictionaries, nested list. We can simply have nested tuples as well. So over here we have a tuple which contains the first value, the second value, the third value is nested, which contains a pair of list, the fourth value and the fifth value is again nested, and similarly the fifth value. Now you can customize your tuple accordingly in a nested tuple. So when we say print tuple t, it is simply going to print your nested tuple like it has printed over here, you can see. And then we say t2 0. Now what it is going to do, it is going to refer to the second value of your tuple and the 0th value of that second value. Now if you refer over here, the 0th value is 5, the first value is 6, and the second value is this entire list which is nested, right? And when we say the 0th index of the second value, the 0th index of the second value is nothing but 7. And we are trying to replace this value with 0. So what it is going to do, it is going to replace this 7 with a 0. Now when we print our tuple t, it's going to get replaced by a 0. So have a look over here. This is the original tuple, and when we say t20 is equal to 7 is equal to 0, it is going to replace this 7 with a 0. Now over here when we say t2, it is going to present us with the entire value contained by the second index of the t tuple. So this is our t tuple. What is the second index? The 0th index is 5, the first index is 6, and the second index is this entire whole nested list. So it is going to present us with this entire list obviously 7 got replaced with 0. Now when we say t22, it means the second value associated with the second index. So we have the second index as this, and the second value associated with this is obviously 12 and 13. This is the 0th index, this is the first index, and then we have the second index as 12 and 13, so it showcases as the 12 and 13. Then when we say t221, what we are trying to say, we want to find out the second indexes, second values, first value. So this is the entire second index, and when we say the second value of the second value, what it does, this is the 0th index, this is the first index, and this is the second index, and the first value associated with this is 13, so it shows us a 13. So that is how you work with nested tuples and nested dictionaries in Python. We'll move ahead in our further video sessions.